This video examines analysis of variance or ANOVA using the SPC for Excel software. What you do with analysis of variance is you try and see what factors have an impact on a certain response. And in this case, our response is going to be battery life. And battery life is the dependent variable in this case. And we're going to look at two factors. We have temperature and material. And we're going to use three levels of each. Temperature has levels of 15, 70, 125 degrees. And then we have three materials, 1, 2, and 3. And what we're going to do is we're going to do an ANOVA design to see how these temperature and or material have an impact on battery life. So to begin, you simply enter the factors and their levels into an Excel spreadsheet along with the response. And then what you want to do is you come to the SPC for Excel ribbon and you select ANOVA from the analysis panel. And it comes up and you have your type of analysis of variance. So it can have crossed, it can be nested, or it can be mixed. We're going to keep it crossed, and then the factors can be fixed, random, or mixed as well. And then you have some other options to show the design or randomize the design. So what we're going to do is we're going to do crossed, and there's only one response, so we're going to select OK. And you enter the range containing the factor names and the levels as shown here, and we simply select that. Number of replications, we're going to do 4 replications with this analysis of variance. And then it says enter the location for the response name. So we select OK for battery life, then we select OK, and we have our design that has been developed into the Excel workbook for us. And what we have is our standard run number, actual run number. It would be in randomized order if we'd selected that option. We have the level of temperature and the level of material. And all we then need to do then is to enter the results into this column for battery life. Well, I already have the results over here, and I'll just copy them over. And at this point, we're ready to run the analysis. Now we're ready to analyze the design. We have a cross design. We're using fixed factors. The response is battery life. We have the two factors, temperature and material, both fixed, 3 levels of each, and they're given here. We have our results entered in now for the 36 runs. So we come back now, and we're ready to analyze it. We go back to ANOVA from the SPC for Excel ribbon, select it. And now we have an output options. One is a variability chart, which we'll take a look at, which can plot the treatment averages, the subgroup averages, the overall averages. We can do a residual analysis, which we'll select. We can do a control chart of the results. We can compare factors and means if we want. We'll skip that. We can display the components of variance and expected mean squares, as well as display F calculation information. Plus, we have a control chart rollout. But we'll just do these options for now. Select OK. And our results are generated. The analysis of variance tables are shown on the first page when the software has done the analysis. And the first one is the ANOVA table for the sources of variation. We have temperature, material, temperature times material, which is the interaction, the within, and the total. And we have the sum of squares, degrees of freedom, mean square F. And then the key thing is the p-value, because p-values less than 0.05 mean that source of variation has a significant impact on battery life. And in this case, all three of them are less than 0.05, and they're turned to red with the software. So temperature, material, and the interaction have a significant impact on battery life. There's also an ANOVA table for the model, which shows again that the model is significant because its p-value is less than 0.05. Then we have some basic statistics from the calculations, including the R-squared value. And then we have the 95% confidence interval for the various treatment means. And also, in this case, since we had selected those options, we have the expected mean squares and how we calculated the F value. Not as critical for fixed factors, but definitely for random factors. Now, we also have what's called a variability chart. And what a variability chart is, it shows the impact of the various levels of material and temperature on the results. So, for example, down here we have our temperatures 15, 70, and 125. And then, for example, for temperature 15, we have the 3 levels of material, 1, 2, and 3. Then we have the 4 results plotted, the average of that treatment, and then the overall average as well. So you can see the impact that they have. And the nice thing about this is you can revise this. For example, suppose we want to switch it, and so we have material on the bottom and temperature on the top. We select OK, and now you can see that the material is down here and the temperatures in here, and you can get a visual picture of how the results change over time. So that's a variability chart. There's also something called the components chart, and what this does is it gives you the components of variation. Temperature is 51.4% of the variation, material 8.8, and temperature interaction with material is about 15.5, and the within is about 24.3. So this shows the various components of variance for this design. The output also includes residual analysis, and that's shown on this page. What we have is our battery life, the actual run. This is the predicted result from our model. Then we have the residuals, our leverage, standardized residuals, internally and externally studentized residuals, Diophant's, and Cook's distance. And those that are in red mean their possibility of an outlier, and you might want to take a look and see if there's something odd about that run. But there's only a couple here on number 3 and number 4 where there's possibly an outlier. Then we also have residual plots. And here's a normal probability plot of the residuals. If this falls along a straight line, it means that there's probably a pretty good fit to the model. And here's the other charts that we have. It's the same as we have in regression, where we can select the chart, the normal plot of residuals, residual versus predicted results, residuals versus actual number, versus the type of residual. And we also come over here to have leverage versus actual run number, Cook's distance versus actual run number. We can do predicted values versus actual values, as shown here. So this is a quick look at how the SPC for Excel software handles the analysis of variance. And remember, there are a lot of options when you do analysis of variance with the software. We have the ability to have cross designs, nested designs, or mixed designs, as well as factors that are random or mixed. Hope you found the video useful. Thank you for taking the time to watch it. Have a great day.